Making an incredible costume can be both wonderful and satisfying, but taking really awesome photos of that costume can really seal the deal. Today, I'm going to show you how to take awesome photos of your costume projects. Hey, greetings there, fellow makers. Bill here. Welcome down to the shop. Today, I'm going to show you how to take fantastic photos and immortalize your wonderful cosplay creations. Now, a while back, I did a little video on how to shoot photos of your props, but that was focused on small indoor settings. Today, we're going to go out into the big wild world and take some photos of our costumes. My brother and his wife recently wanted to get some photos done of their Overwatch costume, so we went on a cosplay photo shoot adventure. Let's quickly start off with gear. We could do a whole video on cameras and gear and everything, but let's keep it simple today. First off, the best camera you have is the one you have with you. Now that might be your cell phone, and don't worry, that'll do just fine. So long as you have a cool costume, a really cool setting, and plenty of light, you can make some fantastic photos with the simplest of gear. If you do want to take things to the next level, most of the entry-level DSLRs that come out these days all take pretty great photos. If you want them to look extra good though, then consider investing in a decent lens. Personally, I really like the very basic 50mm prime f1.8 lenses. You can get them for around 100 to 200 bucks, and they will help your photos look super special. If you're interested in seeing any of the gear that I like to use, we'll have a post over at punishprops.com linked down below with a full list. Okay, gear covered. Let's talk about the next most important thing, your location. First off, pick a spot where you're allowed to shoot. Public property is usually a good bet. Just be sure to make sure you follow any posted rules. Private property can be okay so long as you get permission beforehand and be nice to whomever owns that property. Always leave a spot cleaner than when you got there before. It's worth scouting out places near where you live that are super neat and interesting. For our Overwatch themed shoot, we went with the Gasworks Park in Seattle. Your location doesn't need to perfectly match your costume, but getting something that'll provide an interesting backdrop will set your costume photos apart from the rest. For fantasy themed costumes, you could just find a woodland park and that'll treat you just fine. We like to shoot in our backyard because we have a weird creepy shed. That's been the backdrop for many of our post-apocalyptic themed photos, like our Fallout stuff and even some of our Destiny things. We also have this concrete fence next to our house that actually provided a really good backdrop for all of the cover photos for the Foamsmith book and our Draugr costumes. On a side note, whenever I'm out and about in Seattle, I take photos of locations that I think would make good backdrops. This kind of passive scouting can be invaluable when planning future shoots. For example, Freeway Park in Seattle is great for sci-fi themed photo shoots and it's right behind the convention center. We used it for our Destiny shoot with Lord Shax and the Vex Goblin. I started our Overwatch photo shoot with some indoor shots. It's indoors, but there's plenty of available diffused sunlight inside the pavilion. This provided us with a really easy to shoot soft light on our subjects. No need here for flashes or bounce reflectors. Just setting your camera to its auto settings and then snapping some shots off will yield decent results if you have a great setting and good light like this. I try to get either above or below the eye line of the subject when I'm shooting. In this case, I took most of my shots squatted down so that my models would look more imposing as I looked up at them. We also took some shots outside in direct sunlight. This is really great if you want something more dramatic with incredibly harsh shadows. It really just depends on the look that you want to achieve. You can shoot with the sun to your back, lighting up your cosplayer like a Christmas tree, or you can shoot into the sun, backlighting your subject. This can be a bit more challenging, and it helps to have an assistant with a bounce reflector to fill in the sunlight that you're missing out on. Just know that you're shining the burning sun into your subject's eyes, so don't blind them for more than a couple of seconds at a time while you get your shot.
Oh.
Tears of joy.
Cosplay tears.
Here you can see how a little bit of fill light from a bounce can add that bit of pizzazz to your outdoor photo shoots. Most bounce reflectors can also be used as a shade, so if you can't find any soft light, then you can use the bounce as a shade and help diffuse the light coming into your subject's face. And just like that, you can get great shots right out of the camera. However, if you'd like to get a little more technical, here are a couple of things you can do to push your creativity and create something really special. If you've invested in a couple of different lenses that have different focal lengths or a zoom, or you have a camera that has a built-in optical zoom, try playing around with zooming all the way in versus all the way out. Even if you frame your subject the same way, you can get drastically different results. Here's a shot I took at 200 millimeters and another one I shot at 20 millimeters. For the 200 millimeter shot, I had to get far away to frame it exactly the same. Now, if your camera has a manual exposure setting, you can tinker with the aperture, shutter speed, and ISO to change how much light is captured. You can even get custom camera apps for your phone that will give you some degree of manual control over the exposure. Note that with your shutter speed, you do need to shoot fast enough so that you don't get any motion blur while hand-holding the camera. I tend to go with doubling your focal length. For example, with that 50 millimeter lens, I'll shoot at 1/100th of a second. Here's an example of the 50 millimeter at 1/100th of a second. And then here's one showing the handheld camera shake that I got on that 50 millimeter lens at 1/20th of a second. Shooting in manual exposure mode, you'll notice that the faster you make the shutter speed, the darker the resulting image. So you'll have to lower your aperture to compensate. If your aperture is as low as it can go, you'll have to bump up the ISO to bring up the exposure. And of course, once you've taken your photos, you can eyeball the exposure on your screen on the back of the camera to see if it looks way overexposed or way underexposed. You can also use the histogram. Also check out how the depth of field changes when you adjust the aperture. The higher you go, the more of your frame is in focus and vice versa. This can help you make sure your entire subject is in focus, or if you want to, you can turn the entire background into a super neat blur. Along with that, you can experiment with getting close and far away from your subject to see how that drastically changes the focal distance. More than anything, play with the settings that you have with the camera available to you. With a digital camera, you can take hundreds of photos on a memory card or whatever memory you have in your phone, so you have no reason not to experiment. And of course, the most important thing is, try and have a little bit of fun. Doing cosplay photo shoots can be really fun and exciting, and it's a great excuse to grab some of your friends and go out on an adventure. Hey, I hope this video helped you figure out some good ideas for your next cosplay photo shoot. And I hope I've inspired you and your friends to head out and make something cool. I've linked to some other helpful photography resources down in the description. So if you're looking to dive further into that world, head on down there and start reading. And as always, if you have any questions, please leave them down in the comments. A huge thank you goes out to my brother Rob and his wife Jamie for having us on their photo shoot and letting me shoot this video. Jamie is expecting their next baby very soon, and since her Roadhog cosplay is kind of pregnancy dependent, we had to make sure that we got this photo shoot done soon. So it was a really good excuse to grab our camera and run out and get some cool photos made. Now, of course, if you're looking for more prop and costume making goodness, you can head on over to punishprops.com where you'll find all of our content. Hey, thank you guys again so much for checking out our videos. If you haven't subscribed already, go ahead and do so. We've got new videos coming out every single week. That's all I have for you guys today, and I'll see you all in the next build. Hey, thanks for watching. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe so you don't miss any of our new weekly prop and costume tutorial videos. For more goodies, head over to our website where you'll find blueprints, tutorial books, articles, and more. We also have a second channel for our Q&A show and extra behind the scenes videos. Thanks again and happy crafting.